Hi! In this lesson, we are going to learn how to install global styles to a Storybook. So the first thing that I normally do is to install a reset CSS. A reset CSS is a file that pretends to normalize the styles cross browsers. This is because some browsers has different styles from others. So we want a general base where we can start build our own styles. And the one that I like is called mini reset CSS. In order to install it, we just need to run yarn add mini reset.css. And while this is installing, let's take a look to their website. In their website, they have more details about what this mini reset CSS file does. So basically, it resets the font sizes, it resets the block margins, it resets the tables, it preserves the line paddings, sets border box sizing, and sets responsive and media elements. It's a very small file, pretty easy to understand. And one thing that I really like to do, usually in my projects, is to have the less dependencies as I can. When you have so many dependencies, it's very hard to control your code. Maybe sometimes those dependencies have security problems and you need to wait a lot, or you need to apply fixes on a code that you don't really know in order to make it safe for your own code. So that's why the best way to preserve security and good maintenance of your code is to have the less dependencies as you can. And this is something that we are going to notice in this course. We are going to try to do as much as we can. We are going to install the less dependencies possible. So now that we have your reset CSS as a dependency, it's time to add it to a Storybook. So for that, we go into the Storybook folder, open preview.js, and we are just going to import it. Preview.js is the file that is going into the canvas. So anything that you do here is going to affect the canvas itself. So for that, it's as simple as just import mini reset CSS. And then because I want to add some global styles, I'm going to do this right now. I'm just going to import styles global.css. And as you notice, this file doesn't exist. So let's create it. Let's create a folder here called styles. And inside styles, let's create this file called global.css. And what we are going to put in this file, we are going to set some global styles. So for HTML and the body, I want by default that the height is 100%. And then the font family is going to load a custom property. This custom property doesn't exist either, but later we will create it. And because it's not defined, what we can do when we load custom properties is to define a default value in case this one here doesn't exist. So for this case, I'm going to say that everything is going to be sans serif. This is the default font from the system. And then the same for the font size. So we are going to load this from a custom property, and later you will realize that these custom properties will came from our design tokens, but that's a topic for the future. By default, I want everything to be 10 PS. It's very small, that's true, but it's easy to calculate what is going to be the size, because then we will dynamically refer everything to M sizes. But right now we don't really care. We can change the default value or even change the custom property. Now for the root element, we are going to write some rules, and the same as the HTML and the body, I want this one 100% high. What is the root element? The root element is the div that contains everything in the canvas of the Storybook. So now I'm pretty sure that this is working, but let's just start a Storybook and let's confirm that it's working, in fact. So if I go to my Storybook while this is loading, and let's give it a time, because as I said, the first time that you load the Storybook is going to take a while, and then it's going to be faster. In the future, the Storybook is going to be even faster. So now we have these different styles applied. Maybe we can't really notice anything, but let's do a test. If I go to the canvas here and I say that the background color is going to be tomato, and let's save. Yeah, is working. So yeah, this is basically everything about how to add global styles to a storybook. And you might be wondering why this is important. Some of you have applications that it depends on global styles and you don't really know how to apply it to a storybook. So in our next lesson, we are going to finally add our first story in a storybook. See you in the next one.